handling. Now, before that, what are the errors that you are facing when you write a program? What are the what will be the errors you will face when you write a program? There are normally you will have two types of errors. When you write a program, you will face two types of errors. What are the two types of errors? So it's like runtime error or compile time error, like that. Tell me an example for runtime error. Compile time error, for example, if I forgot to put a dot after system, it will give you a compile time error. What is runtime error? For example, in a real time scenario, I want to fetch some data from a file using a Java program, but that particular file is not available in your drive. Then you will get an error called file not found. Similarly, when you are trying for a web page which is not available, okay, and it will show you an error called web page 404 file not found, like that you'll get. So that kind of exception, that kind of problem is said to be a runtime problem. And this runtime problem, there are normally we have like two types of errors. One is said to be a syntax error, and another is said to be a semantic error. The syntax error is otherwise called as compile time error, and the semantic is said to be a runtime error. So who will take care of this compile time error? So who will tell you that you are doing some this kind of error in a program like that? So who will do that, and who will take care of this compile time error? Is our compiler itself will take care of this compile time error. Okay, and who will take care of this runtime error? Is we should take care of this runtime error, and only our program will able to identify what kind of error, and it will show you some kind of descriptive information about the error, and it will show you that. For example, like when you create an array of size 10 and you are trying to assign the value in the 11th position, it is not possible. So it will give you an error. What the Java does is, there is a error handling mechanism called exception handling mechanism, in which it will provide you an error. Okay, it will give you some description about error. So there is a base class. So we know that the base class for all the Java is, the base class for all Java classes, object. Okay, and the base class for all the exception is exception handling classes, exception itself. So the base class for all the exception handling classes, exception itself. So you can see that here. So you can type Java P space Java dot IO dot exception. Sorry, it's like Java dot lang dot exception. Sorry. Okay. So this lang dot exception. Okay. So this is the base class for all the exception. You can see. For example, if I want to explore like Java dot lang dot arithmetic exception. Like that, if I search, you can see this arithmetic exception is a derived class of the base class runtime exception. Now this runtime exception, you can see again, you can explore Java P space Java dot lang dot runtime exception. So this runtime exception has the base class called java.lang.exception. So the base class for all the exception is exception itself. So that you have to get understand. So now what kind of inheritance it's providing? Like you can see, like arithmetic exception is a derived class of the runtime exception. So arithmetic exception is a derived class of runtime exception. So runtime exception is a base class for arithmetic exception. But when you see here, runtime exception is a derived class of the base class exception called exception. So this runtime, so this provides a multi-level kind of inheritance. Okay, so every packages and every classes in Java is like, it is created with the help of inheritance concept, so that everyone can use it and they can reuse it, or it is suitable for all the applications like that. So moving on to this application, we'll write some small applications with the exception handling mechanism. What I will do is, I will just demonstrate some different kinds of exceptions. So first, the main kind of exception is like divide by zero exception. So normally anything divided by zero is infinity, and infinity is not a result actually. So the result, it will not there is no result called infinity. So to do that, we can have like exception handling mechanism like that. So for example, first we'll have a class name exception demo, then public static void main. Then string args like that. When you do an exception handling mechanism, it is best way that you have to import the package java.io.star. Because normally in exception handling mechanism, we'll get the content from the user. Then you have to put something here like exception throws exception like that, or you can have the concept like this. So in exception handling mechanism, we can have like three blocks of exception handling mechanism. One is try, then another one is catch. So in the catch, we'll have the base class exception E, so that it will throw all the kind of exception it can find. Then it will have something called finally, like that. For example, let me work like int a equal to 10 like that, int b equal to 0. What I'm trying to do is int c is equal to a divided by b, and I'm trying to print that. So what we'll do is we'll write the code in which we want to check. We'll put that in try, and what happens if this code fails? It will produce the error information with the help of system.out.println e, like that. So the code in which I want to test, you can put it in try. What happened, like if the code fails, it will show you the necessary information about the error. It will do here in this section. And if both has completed, then it will have a optional block called a finally block. So it will provide some extra information like finally completed, like that. It's an optional block. You can have like finally, or you cannot have a finally, like it's an optional block. So now I will save this as exception demo. Exception demo. Okay, and save it. Then Java C exception demo dot Java exception demo. When I press enter, we'll get the error. Like it is executing, it is assigning the value of a equal to 10, b equal to 0. Then it is calculating the c as a by b, and it's trying to print C, but this is like a runtime error or a semantic error. So it is calling this base class exception, and this base class exception is taking the necessary exception handling mechanism, and it is showing what is the exception we are having. And finally it is printing like we are having the arithmetic exception divide by zero, and after doing that it is printing the finally block. It's an optional block. We can also delete that. It's, since it's an optional one, we can delete that. And if you do the same thing, it's like it won't do anything. Like, but finally, it's just an optional block. Either you can have it or cannot have it. So this is one kind of exception called arithmetic exception divide by zero. So this divide by zero is like it will give an infinity result, but that is not possible. So it is showing an error called arithmetic exception. Okay, so I will explain this again. This exception handling mechanism is allow us to like allow the program to check for any semantic error in the program. So it has three blocks normally: try, catch, and finally. The program in which I want to try, or the code in which I want to check, I can put that in try. And what happens if it fails? If it fails, it should show some error message like system.out.println e. That means it will provide the standard error message. Then once it's completing this try and catch, it will enter into the optional block called finally, and it will print something like finally or completed like that. Here the program is like I have created two variables, a equal to 10 and b equal to 0. In the program, I'm in the try block, I'm going to check whether 10 by 0, whether it will print or not. What it will do is, coming to this section, it will have 10 by 0. Now C value is said to be it's undefined or it's an infinity. Since infinity is not the result, it will not print the C, and it will go to this catch block. And it will, in the catch block, it will just print what is the error or what is the exception that this C is having. And it will print the exception handling error like this, and it will go to the finally block. What happens if I change this B equal to 10? So it will go to the C that is 10 by 10 equal to 1, and it will print 1, and it will not go to the catch block, and it will go to the finally block. So let me compile. Let me run. So it will we'll get 1, and it will go to the finally block. If it works well, that means if there is no problem in this code, it will directly go to the finally block. If there is any problem in this code, it will go to the exception handling mechanism, and it will show the error of what we are going to have like that. So this is like arithmetic exception, that is divide by zero. Okay, so this is like arithmetic exception. You can see java.clang.arithmeticException. You can also explore that java p java.lang.arithmeticException. So you can see this arithmetic exception again extends runtime exception. So what you can have is java p space java.lang.runtime exception. So you can see this java.lang.runtime exception is having another exception. So we are directly using this base class, so exception e like that, and we are printing this object e like that. So any doubt in the exception handling in the type like arithmetic exception like that, any doubt in that? Okay, so now we'll go for another kind of exception where, assuming I have an array of size 10, for example. So let me just put some value here so that it will not produce arithmetic exception. I have an array, for example, I have an array of size, for example, I have some value as 10, 20, 30 like that. And I was trying to put like the fifth position with the value 90. Okay. So I have created an array of size 3 because I have only three values. If I try to assign the fifth position with a value 90, we will see what kind of error it will throw. So this produces something called array index out of bounds exception. Okay. So this concept is called as array index out of bounds exception. There is no index called 5 because we have only three index, that is 0, 1 and 2. We don't have something called fifth position in the array, but we are trying to assign the value here. But since it's not possible, so it will show you an error. What happen if I assign like minus fifth position, maybe? The same thing, array index out of bounds exception, it will happen. So what happen if I assign to second position? That means 0, 1, 2. So it will replace this 30 with 90. It will not show any error. Okay. So if I want to print something here, system dot, so suppose if I want to print the array, whole array, I can put int I equal to 0, I less than array dot length, I plus plus system dot out dot println array of I can see the third value is replaced with 90. There won't be any issues because since the position is there, position 2 is there, it is assigning the value as 90. Suppose what happens if I give 5, the position is not available. So position is not available. So it is showing an array index out of bounds exception. So this is all about exception handling. There are so many exception handling mechanism in which we will learn when we go for the courses in progress. Like we'll have like class not found exception, then we'll have like the jar files cannot be found exception. There are plenty of exception things are available, but as the course progress, we will have some clear understanding about that. Okay. So far this is all about exception handling mechanism, and we'll have something called try and catch, and finally and try the code in which we want to test, we can put it in try, and if there is any bug, it will throw and catch, and finally it's just an optional block in which we can have some just to describe some information, we can have some finally like that. So any doubt in this, any question, so that we can take for some a minute. Any doubt?